Hi dolls, it's your girl Allie. Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, click on the subscribe button. And if you're not new, welcome back. Today I'll be talking about, not today. Today will be a get ready with me because I've been getting a lot of requests from you guys that wanted me to do a makeup tutorial. I am not a makeup artist, but I'll do my best. This is just pretty much an everyday makeup I do when I go out with my friends or when I'm at work. So I'm just going to show you guys how I do my makeup. Today, let's see. So everyone always starts differently. Everyone always start with like the face first, like contour, with the foundation. But with me, since I had microblading on my eyebrows, I don't really focus on my eyebrows so much. Since it's already done, I just kind of concealer just the bottom. And today I'm using, this is like some drugstore stuff, but it's by Col-Lab, and it's in the color of porcelain. So I'll put this under my eyebrows just to kind of conceal it a little bit. I usually just do it all over the lid because I'm just going to use it as my base when I put my eyeshadow. And then do the other side. Just like that. Then you grab one of your sponge. This is kind of janky, but just grab one of your sponge, kind of add some water so it kind of be a little damp like that. And then what I do is just kind of press it in and make sure you get it all in your brows. Just like that. And then grab one of your little flat brush. This is a definitely lifesaver, you guys. Like, it will clean up all your brushes. And you just kind of swirl it like that. Kind of clean up all like the leftover eyeshadow you used from like the previous night or a week ago or, you know, all your dirty hoes. But yeah, so clean it really, really good like that. And then I like using this palette by Melissa Michelle. It's kind of old. Obviously, you can tell I've been using it a lot. I'm going to be going in for the Lola. And I use this on my eyebrow bone to kind of highlight my brow bone. So this is pretty much my everyday look I always go for. I always just go for the Lola on my eyebrow bone because, you know, she like that popping. She like it highlighted. Make sure you do the other side. Oh, look at that. That was like Am I blind yet? Yes, I am. So I just smoked some weed earlier because I had to like help kind of get me going, because obviously if I don't, I feel like I get really shy and I keep saying the same thing over and over. So weed kind of helped me, you know. Y'all smoke weed. All right, so what are we gonna do today? I think we're gonna go probably like a fall color, because today it's like November. Oh, November 1st. Happy November 1st, y'all. So we're probably gonna do like a fall color. So I'm thinking of like an orange mixed with kind of brown on my crease. But I'm gonna use this is called Bing Bing. This one right here, this orangey color. Actually, no, I'm gonna use this rosemary color. It's like a beigey brown. I use this on the top here. This is gonna be my transition color. So I use the lighter color for my transition to kind of get where I need to start my transition. My eyes is weird, you guys. Like, for some reason, this eyes is a lot more bigger than this one. It's more slanted. So what I do is I try to get it as more rounded as you can get. So I use a lighter color to kind of create that shape. Like that. And then just kind of dust all the excess color. And just kind of fluff it out like this. Like that. And then do the other side. Oh yeah, so how was everyone Halloween? Mine was pretty cool. I took my god kids to trick-or-treating, and it was like my first time, because usually every year I'm always like throwing parties, or I'm always going out and spending so much freaking money. And honestly, I was just like, you know what, I'm just gonna stay in. But then my best friend hit me up and was like, hey, we should take the kid to go trick-or-treating. And I'm like, ooh, I've been wanting to do that for so long. And my god kids, they're a boy and a girl. One is Hudson, the other one is Malia. They're so freaking cute. And yeah, we went trick-or-treating, and honestly, you guys, we only stayed for 2 hours. 2 hours of trick-or-treating, we were already tired. Well, the kids was really tired. They were like fussing and crying, and they were hungry and they were, you know, thirsty. So we decided to leave. We probably went around two blocks, but honestly, they were like bucket, and it was like filled with candy. So, and I don't know, but when I was younger, like trick-or-treating used to be fun, and there used to be more kids out. And I feel like this year, they're not as much kid out anymore. And then too, like, they like died down so early. Like, it was, like, usually it would die down like around 10 or 11 when I was younger. But now it died down like around 9. Like, what the hell? It's not the same anymore. And there's not that much kid out trick-or-treating either. I feel like they'd be acting all bougie. They'd be like, oh, hell no. It's all that electronic shit. And Fortnite. All them kids. They be playing Fortnite. I don't even know what that is. I don't even play that game. Alright, so that, I go back with my flat brush and grab that Lola again, because I feel like I went too freaking high. So I just like to kind of go over and kind of make my eyebrow bone pop a little bit more. Okay, like that. Then I go back with this brush. I don't know what this brush is, but it's kind of janky, but it works. I use that for my crease, and what I'm gonna use is, make sure you guys clean that brush, because it's hella dirty. It's from my makeup from the from last night, because I went trick-or-treating, but I dressed up. I was Sugar Skull, Till Death Do Us Part, yeah. And you guys can see, I had on a white wig with, like, I made this really cute headdress. And I did it all last minute. Honestly, you guys, when I come to my creative side, I'm, like, very focused. So maybe one day I'll do another tutorial on how to make, like, stuff last minute. And on a budget, too. Alright, so I'm gonna use this brush. This is by e.l.f. And it's just a professional... Oh, it's a blending brush. A blending eye brush. But honestly, I like this one by Sephora better for the blending part, because it works better. This is just too together. But anyways, I use... This is Harley. Obviously, you can tell I've been using it a lot. I always use that for my crease. So what I do, I kind of close my eyes a little bit to kind of find where that corner is. So what I do is I kind of just darken my crease, but how I find my crease is it's my little eye socket. Your eye socket is the crease. So just kind of darken it, but blending it out too, because with this brush, if you don't blend it out, then it just looks too harsh and it's just gonna look hella fucking dark and it just looks like you have a black eye. And nobody wants a black eye. Unless you're in a fight. And you ain't trying to ruin your makeup or your nails. So you're like, bitch. I'm even more excited because I have contacts on now, because without these contacts, because I have a mirror right here, you guys, and if I don't have my contact in, I can't see jack shit. It will be hella fucking blurry. You'll be seeing a fucking hot mess freaking makeup tutorial. But thank God to my niece. She got me some contacts. So now I can finally see. I'm not blind anymore. My friends always like, Allie, why are you not wearing freaking glasses or contacts? I'm like, well, because I don't have any. I'm just like, I don't know. I feel like I don't need it. But then sometimes I do, because then I can't see when I drive. And that's bad. But now I have it, so I'm not a crazy Asian driver anymore. I'm a very smart Asian driver. So I like to darken that dark area like that. Just kind of, like I said, find your little socket where your eyeball is and just kind of darken it. Like that, you know? Don't mind, it's kind of messy up there, but that's okay because you're going to go back with the concealer. Want to kind of clean off the ashes because it's a little bit too much. But what I do is I need a different type of mirror. Let me grab another mirror thingy. Okay. So since I'm mirrored kind of too far, I'm gonna use this a little bit to kind of go. But I use this on my lid. So you kind of create a lid like this. Since I have kind of type no damn lid at all. Just kind of create your own lids. So do that on this side. Like a half moon, or is it a half moon? Is it a half moon? I don't know if this is a half moon or not. But anyways, it looks like that. And then you want to take your flat brush again. Make sure you clean up all the excess color that you used from the previous palette. And then what I do is just kind of pat it in. Just kind of pat it like this. Because you want to set it without rubbing it. Just pat. Because I feel like if you kind of rub it like this, you kind of take off all the concealer. And you kind of... I don't want that. Because then I'm going to have to redo my makeup. And it's not cute. And a girl is not trying to redo her makeup. She's trying to hurry the hell up so we can go... like that. Oh, I look cutesy. Okay, so what I do is I like to use a lighter color eyeshadow. So I am going to go for Kat Von D. I love this palette. Obviously, I only use a few, but I'm gonna go for this color here. This one is called Etymology. Wow, you guys, I don't know. Well, Etymology. We're gonna put up a description right like that. But I'm using that on my lid. So just pat that color, and I like this color because it has like a shimmer, like it's like a yellow, and it, but it has like a shimmer to it, which is pretty cool. And since we are going out at night, it's nice to have a little shimmer without adding too much like glitter, you know. So obviously the top, you can kind of see, I kind of messed that up, but it's okay. I'm gonna go back in with this brush and go grab the Harley, which is the brown, and go back in over on top and just kind of blend that out as well, blending the your base lid color as well, so oh, it looks more blended and it's not so harsh like that. Then again, if you wanted to darken it, deepen it, you can always add more color, but I think I'm not gonna darken it too much because I'm already gonna use eyeliner to kind of, that's already gonna exaggerate it. So I don't really need to darken it too much, just enough. And then do the same thing on this side. So, like that. You can kind of see the transition. It went from, I did the Lola for my eyebrow bone, then I did the Rosemary as my blending to start off my transition color. Then I used the Bing Bing as the to darken it for the orange. And then I went in for my crease for the Harley. And then I went in, oh yeah, what did I say? Oh yeah, I did the eyelids. Okay, so that's done for that eyes. Then I like to grab my eyeliner. I am using, this is my all-time favorite eyeliner. It's waterproof. I like waterproof because if my eyes get teary and stuff like that, it doesn't come off. It like literally stays intact. But this is pretty much at like a boutique store. You can't really see it, but it's like this. And what I like about it too, it smells so good. It smells like some like rosemary like freaking thingy. It's so cool. I promise you, I don't get high on this stuff. Alright. Okay, so I'm gonna go in and do my eyeliner. This part I usually like always have tape right here, but I can't find any tape. Let's see. You know what? I'm gonna use this tape thingy right here. If I could take it out. But oh look, I can't. Okay. So what I like to do is I use the tape right underneath my eyes. Like this. Like that, you guys. And then this one, this is how I kind of create that wing, because I can't like freehand it. Like I don't know how to freehand it like all those makeup artist people do. They're really professional. Like I said, you guys, I'm not professional. I'm more of a hairstylist, but I like to do makeup for fun, but I like to show you guys how I do my makeup when I go out. So I do another. Make sure it's even, because sometimes like eyeliner would come off retarded looking. I think that's even, or probably not. Not that. Not even. Can you see it? Thumbs up. Okay. Okay. Alright, you guys, so I'm gonna go in with the eyeliner. So what I do first is I start off with the wing, and then I'll go in into my my inner corner eye. So I'll start from here. So wherever, how long or how short or how the angle you create your wings, that's how it's gonna look. So what I do is I like to start from here. I don't know if you guys can see, but I have like this bone that sticks out right here. So that's like my starting point to start my wings. So I just like to and then just kind of go like that. And then I go into my inner. And just connect it. Make sure you guys connect that together so it looks like that. And then once you guys take off the tape, that shit's gonna pop in. You're gonna be like, damn, I'm a professional. Thanks to Allie. Okay. Then you do the other side. Make sure it looks good and not retarded. So I'm gonna fix my left side a little bit and make it a little bit more thicker, because I feel like the other side's a lot thicker than this side. That looks good, right? Thumbs up. Talking to my cameraman. He's being all shy. Okay. So what I do is then you take off the tape. Bam. Look at that. That looks bomb. So that's how I create my wings. But obviously this side's a little bit more longer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take them out a little bit. Let me grab some Q-tip. Where is my Q-tip though? I'll be right back, you guys. Give me a second. I'm back, y'all. Alright, so I went to go grab my Q-tip. What I do is, so this side is a lot shorter, you guys can see. You guys can see this is a lot shorter. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this one a little shorter like this so it looks more even. Or actually, you know what? Since I like the longer version anyway, we're just gonna maybe do this one a little longer too. How's that? Bam! Damn! Who's that though? She's popping, y'all. She's popping. All right. So we did that. We did the eyeliner. So what I'm gonna do next is curl my lashes. See, since with mine, my lashes, like, it kind of angles down. I have to curl them so they look decent. So when I put my lashes on, it will kind of blend in together. So I'm going to go next is I'm going to use my LA Colors HD Waterproof Mascara. Like I said, I like to use waterproof, everything waterproof. I don't want that shit running down. Like them Disney characters when they're crying and their mug is all ruined and shit. We don't want that. Just like that. Yay. So then now I'm gonna go in with my lashes. I am using Ardell lashes. Forgot what number this is, but I think it's like 241 or 251. But they're really hella extra, just like me. So we're gonna go for them extra lashes, cause you know we're going out at Thirsty Thursday. You know, I'm trying to get drunk, trying to get wasted and not remember what happened the next day. Now that's a party. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with my lashes. I'm gonna use my glue. This is literally the best eyelash glue ever. Like, ever. It is dual and it's a brush on adhesive with a vitamin, which is pretty awesome. And it's pretty much, it's like a brush on. It's like a little brush on there and it has the glue on there, which is pretty cool because, I used to like have the other one with the one with the squeeze. That one I don't like it because it's too messy. This one is just much better. It's more it just glides on really smooth. So you just pretty much put your eyelash glue on the strip like that. Make sure you get it from each corner and in the middle and everywhere. I mean not everywhere, but just make sure it's on that strip. Because that it's gonna go on your lid, where I mean not on your lid but on your lash lid, and that will kind of give you more pizzazz. So you want to blow it a little bit, make sure it is the right one that you're putting. Because you don't want to put the wrong. I did that one time and my friends was like, what's wrong with your lashes? So you want to put that right on top. Like that. Make sure you get it on your lashes. and not on your lashes, on the lash lid, because when you go and take them out, you don't want it on your lashes because you're gonna rip it out, and that shit is not cute. We don't want you missing no hairs on your lashes. And don't be trying to blame me, because I told your ass. Alright, so then grab the other one. So, I'm pretty sure you guys noticed that I take my time doing my, like, eyes. That's because I feel like that's what people look at the most. And then they kind of go and look everywhere else. So, I always want to make sure my eyes are, like, popping. Because, you know, if your eyes ain't popping, girl, your whole life ain't popping. Honestly, I feel like I should be smoking weed all the time because I'm so damn talkative. I'm always having so much stuff to say when I'm not high. So she's definitely 420 friendly. If y'all see me on the street and y'all smoking, you better hit a girl up. Don't be trying to leave me hanging, though. So I'm trying to get this lashes, but it's like being retarded. So you want to kind of tuck that in, because if you have it on top of your lid, then when you look up, it looks weird. So make sure you like kind of tuck it in so it looks better. And make sure you kind of blend it in with your lashes as well. So then I like to go back with my mascara again and kind of blend it in with the top lashes. Like that. Bam! I didn't even look. This one. Look okay? Cool. I have to ask my cameraman, y'all, because I can't. Sometimes, like, when I look at myself, I'm like, I don't know. Did I even look okay? Okay, I look good. Okay, so then I go back in with this brush, the blending brush thingy, majiggy, and go back in with Harley from Melissa Michelle palette, and I like to go underneath and kind of darken it a little bit. Actually, no, I did it wrong. Not darken it. We don't want to do that yet. This when it comes to, then it comes to foundation. So it comes to foundation, and then I like to do my under eye like after. So we're gonna do this first. I like to use, sorry it's all messy, but I like to use Fenty Beauty. And it is by Rihanna. This literally, you guys, is by far the best freaking foundation ever. Like, it makes my face really, really matte. The thing is with me, I have really oily skin, so if I use any like dewy makeup or any like just not matte, like my face get dewy and it gets very like oily. So I try to avoid that and try to get rid of that. But everyone's face is different. So it could be, you can have dry skin or you can have a combination or you can have oily skin or whatever. So go whatever foundation that fits your face. But I mean, you don't have to go, and I'm not telling you to go out and go get Fenty because this shit is expensive. But go whatever. You can use I like to use CoverGirl. I forgot what's it called, but it's CoverGirl, and it's a matte finish. Or you can use anything, honestly, you can use any drugstore makeup. As on whatever you're comfortable with and whatever's in your budget, okay? So, but what I'm gonna use, this is what I have, and this is what I'm gonna use. I'm using this Pro Filter. It's a soft matte longwear foundation. You gotta shake it, make sure it is well shake. What I do is I like to, actually before that, I like to use this Never Touch Up Face Primer. This, you guys, is the best pore. It's like goodbye pore. So if you have like really, really deep pores like me, well, before I used to have really, really deep pores, and like when I put on makeup, like my makeup never goes on really smooth. And now it does, because I've been like, you know, taking care of my face and just scrubbing and using certain like product for my face. I use Neutrogena face wash, and I use this other product by Olay. It's like a blemishing cleanser, and I use that, and I use this like really soft bristle scrubber for my face. You can get that at a Dollar Tree. Like, it's really cheap. It's only like a dollar and you get two. So like, it's like a face scrubber, and you use it for your face, and it's literally like the softest bristle ever. I've used like all type of brushes before, but they're so harsh on my skin, and I feel like they're just, my skin breaks out like really easy. As you can tell, it looks like I have a bite mark right here, like a vampire bite mark, but it's not. It's called pimples. So, but yeah, you guys can use like any type of face wash or whatever product or whatever. So yeah, get back into this makeup tutorial, because I feel like it's like forever. Sorry, but you know, y'all love me. You know y'all want to listen to me all freaking day. So I like to rub that all over my face, like this. And make sure you get it all the way to your neck, because you don't want to have your face looking different color than your neck. So make sure you rub that in. And what I like about this Goodbye Pores product, it reduced the appearance of fine lines and pores, and it's oil-free, which is freaking amazing, you guys. So go get them. It's super cool. And I like it because it doesn't leave really like residue or anything like that. It leaves your skin really smooth and very like this like beautiful canvas. Just like me. Alright. So then I go in. I do about 2 pumps. 1, 2. And what I do is I start on my cheeks, and then what is pretty cool about this, make sure with this too, with this foundation, you guys, it's matte, so when it dries up, it dries matte. So when you're using a sponge, make sure it's damp, because when it's not damp and when you put it on your face, it leaves like this like screech on your face, and it's not cute. So you want to damp it to kind of blend in the makeup, and make sure, like I said, get it all the way to your neck and kind of blend it down, because you don't want your face and your body to look a two different color. And I've seen a lot of girls with like two different thing, you know. So that's not cute. We don't want that. So make sure you blend it all in. Obviously, there's no more, because like I said, it dries up really quickly. So that's why I say make sure you damp your sponge, and then just kind of blend it in. And what I like about this foundation as well, you guys, it's the best, and it covers all my bad blemishes, and that pimple that you guys see, obviously it's not there, like it definitely like cover it up. And I like this foundation too, is because it leaves my face really matte, very, very matte, and I like matte look. I like to look like a porcelain doll. I'm very like, because I have like fine lines and wrinkles. You guys probably like, girl, you don't have fine lines and wrinkles. Yes, I do. Okay. I have fine lines. I have it right under where my smile is. And then, and like up here. But this does wonders, and it covers literally almost every little thing. So just making sure and getting the crease on your nose, because a lot of people always leave this out, and you don't want to leave that out. You want to make sure you get that in there. Just like that. Wow, she's coming together. Alright. So then I go back in and using the same concealer that I use for my eyebrows, to conceal my eyebrows and to use for my base for my eyelid, I'm gonna use this as my highlighter as well. So what I do, since this dries up pretty matte, I don't even go in and use a powder on my face to kind of set it, because I feel like this are pretty much already set as it is, which is pretty cool. So it's not like you're not having so much makeup on your face. So what I do is I just go in with the concealer, and then I go underneath here and just conceal my under eye. Kind of cover up that dark circle, you know, from a night of drinking, from a night of hookering. I'm kidding. How about the hookering part? So make sure. Highlight. Moon data chin. Right here. Snatch that nose. Cause she wants that nose to be snatched, honey. And put that dot right there. And you always want to highlight up here as well. I feel like this is your T-zone. This is what you guys is going to do. This is the T-zone. This is how you create your, where you highlight your features and you want it to kind of pop. And whatever you don't want it to pop, that's when you darken in with a darker color. So I don't like using too dark of a darker color. Oh yeah. Don't forget to blend that shit out. But anyways, blend it out first. So you blend it out, make sure you blend it real good. You don't, like I said, don't want to leave any like harsh line. So you want to blend it all the way down. You can even blend all the way down, doesn't even matter. Like I said, do whatever you guys feel comfortable. You guys don't have to do exactly how I did. If you guys don't have the product that I have, it's okay. You can work whatever you guys feel like. This is the product I have and this is what works for me. And this is what I do every day, so, or whenever I do my makeup, I put in my, this is the method I do it. Like I said, you guys can do whatever, however you want it, whatever you feel comfortable in. So make sure you kind of blend that out pretty good. Make sure there's no harsh line. You can always blend the side of your temple, and the side of the temple as well. And you want it like this. Bam. Now you look more bright. It looks more, your eyes are more open, and you're not like sleepy. You know, you have like bags on your head. So, I'm going to go in with this translucent powder. It's by Luxe Pro Powder. This is really cool. I like this one. Like I said, I like using a lighter color for my under eye just to, so I could like to be more brightened. So, I'm using porcelain. And I like to kind of put it on some of this little compact palette thingy. I usually just go in with the same janky brush, janky sponge. And then I'll dip in for that powder, and you're gonna go right underneath the eyes. Everyone does it differently, but this is how I do it. Probably some of you guys will be like, girl, you're doing it all wrong, that's not how you do it. You know, I don't give a rat's ass. I'ma do however the fuck I wanna do, and if you don't like it, you can kiss my ass. So I'm just gonna go under the eyes like this, this will definitely help set the under eye concealer. And then I have to go in here and here as well. And for your nose, make sure you set that powder for your nose and as well on top of your forehead. Like this. And then what I do next is I'm gonna go in with my brush. This is a fluffy brush. This is by Sonia Kashuk. Don't hate me when I can't say a freaking word, okay? I'm not in a spelling bee. So, I'm gonna use my Makeup Forever Pro Bronze Fusion. This is the best. Obviously, you can tell I've been using it a lot because I love it, love it. This will give me more a golden deeper contour because I, like I said, I really don't go too dark of a contour because I'm not, I mean, I'm going out, but I'm not like performing. I think the only time I'm using a darker, when you guys see me using a darker contour, is performing. I do shows as well. But yeah. So I like to go in there and then I go like this, you know, make your face all weird looking. And you're trying to find your cheek, your under cheekbone, because you're going to go right underneath the cheekbone. And you're just going to blend that in like that. I like to go a little higher just to kind of give it more of a definition. So I'll go in up a little higher, upper to the temple. And then just kind of blend that in. You can always deepen it a little more. Like I said, with this bronzer, the more you deeper, the more it's gonna look more bronzy, and that's what I'm trying to go for. I'm trying to go for more bronzy, like, look. Because I'm really pale during the winter, so if I don't bronze up my face, I look like a damn vampire. And, you know, she ain't trying to look like a vampire, so. So just make sure you do on the other side as well. Just blend that in. You can go up a little higher where you did your highlight on your translucent powder and make sure you kind of go in with the temples. And just go in here with that. Make sure you get your hairline. I have a really far back hairline. So I like to kind of deepen it a little bit so it looks like my forehead's a lot smaller and you're more focused just here and not so much the outside. And that's what we're going for. We're going for more a smaller face. So you do that. Wow, it's coming together. Make sure you guys get your jawline as well. Soften up that jawline. If you have like a harsh jawline like mine, what you do is you just soften up. So using like the same bronzer for your contour, you use it for your jawline. That will soften it up and make your jawline look a lot more smaller and not so wide. And then like I said, make sure you blend it all the way down to your neck. Because when you create, when you soften up here and then you just stop right here, it literally looks like you have a freaking 5 o'clock shadow. So make sure, girls, blend that contour down all the way to your necks so it doesn't look like you have a 5 o'clock shadow, so it just looks more together, you know? So do that. Okay, good. What I like to do next is I like to use my finger because there's no brush ever that will help me contour my nose how I want it to be. So my finger will do the justice. What I like to do is I like to find my bridge of my nose. So this is my bridge. So since you already can rate that you have that setting powder already on your nose, you just kind of go in. You can use a brush on this one. Like I said, do whatever you feel comfortable. So I'm going to use my finger. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create my contour my nose because we wanted to make it look smaller. So the highlight of the nose makes, that's more the focus point. And to deepen it, that will kind of make it look smaller, which is pretty cool. Everyone does it differently. This is how I do mine. Like I said, do whatever you feel comfortable. There's no wrong or right answer how you do your makeup, or there's no wrong or right way how to do your makeup. Makeup is freely. You do whatever you feel like or whatever you feel comfortable. Makeup is an expression of who you are. So like that. Now my nose is snatched for the gods, you guys. I like to darken it a little bit more just to kind of give it more deeper. Make sure you get the bottom part because you want to kind of cut off that. So it looks like that. Then what I do next is I'll go in with my big fluffy brush. This is by Sephora as well. This is I can't really see this. It's a round powder brush. Perfect. That's what we're trying to go for. So what I do with this brush is I'll go in, like I said, I don't really put too much powder on my face because I already have the setting powder. So what I do is I'm just going to go in a little bit and grab this powder. It's a pressed powder, photo focus powder compact thingy, and it's a natural buff color. So it's pretty natural. Like I said, it's not going to show any color and it's not going to change my foundation color, which is pretty cool. So what I do is I just go and flush it like this, and I go in and I pretty much just blend everything together, blend that out. Make sure you get your nose as well. Get your neck as well, because like I said, you don't want to have two different tones. Make sure you get the neck. Look like that. Then I like to go in a little bit more, because since you kind of brushed that out, you want to go in a little bit more with this, just to kind of deepen it a little bit more. Like this too. Just do the nose. Like that. Okay. So then now we're gonna do my under eyes. So I'm gonna go back and use Harley. I'm gonna use a different brush for that. Probably gonna use this flat brush here. It's like a dual brush. I get this at Elf. You can get it at Elf. I think it's by Elf. No, actually it's by Anastasia. Oh no, it was in this palette. It was in the Primism Anastasia palette. You get like a little sample brush, and I like it because it's flat. And I pretty much can get it right underneath my eyes. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use Harley and mix it with Bing Bing, that kind of orangey color, and go underneath this to kind of pull all the makeup together. Make sure you blend it out so it doesn't look so... I think I fucked it up. That there was like a black ass color in here. No. Oh well. Okay. I'm gonna just try to blend out as much as I can. Does that look okay? Does that look like I have black in there? It does, huh? Uh-oh, let's see. Maybe we'll figure it out. God. So since I have black in there a little bit, I'm just gonna darken up a little bit more. I said I wasn't gonna darken it, but oh well, cause she effed it up. But it's okay. It looks good. Okay. Then grab your mascara. I don't like to do eyeliner on my bottom lashes, so I just like to use mascara and just kind of go in. Barely have any lashes on my bottom, but it's okay. So just as long you get your bottom lashes, Wow, you guys, we're almost done. Okay, so our next thingy is blush. Make sure you clean out that. A lot of my brushes has a lot of black powder on it because I was a sugar skull for Halloween, so I use a lot of my black. If you guys go to my IG post, or you guys follow me, you guys will see a post that I post up of my sugar skull makeup. If you guys want to see that tutorial, send me a link or comment below, and let me know if you guys want to see me to do. Maybe we can create another sugar skull look. I'm totally down to do it. It was so much fun doing it. It took me about 2 hours, so it literally took forever. So, okay, we're gonna go back to this. We're gonna use Maybelline, and it's it has three little thingy. I'm gonna go for the pink. I'm just gonna brush it a little bit. Love it. And then now we're gonna go for the highlights. So I like to, before I put my highlight, if you want to intensify the highlight and make it more pop, go and spritz your face with this. You can use any makeup setting spray. You can even use hairspray. Honestly, if you guys can't afford setting spray, you can mix water, half water, and spray a can of hairspray into the bottle. And that will give you freaking exactly the same thing. That's what I do all the time when I don't have, you know, money to go get this. Then I used to just do on the budget, and it works the same. But actually went out and got this. Sorry, went to go get this. This is Forever Plus Ever makeup setting spray. And it's a long lasting matte finish. Matte, y'all. I like matte. So all my makeup, literally, it's all matte finish. If I don't have any matte finish makeup, I don't use it, because like it doesn't work well for my face. So what you do is you kind of spritz. That smells good. I like to drip myself like I'm like in a fucking waterfall. Like all wet and shit. Like, so yeah. So let that dry, kind of fan it out like this. I usually have a blow dryer to blow dry my face, but it's too far. I don't want to go and get it. It's just too extra. And I'm sure y'all probably be like, hurry up, Allie. We just want to see the finishing touch. Well, you can't rush beauty, okay? Beauty take time. It does. So I'm going to go in with this brush here. Make sure you kind of clean that off. Since I already sprayed my face, when you put your highlighter on, which is pretty cool, it intensifies it and makes it more pop. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to make my highlight pop. Because honestly, I get compliment when I go out. Like, people are like, oh my god, your highlight is popping. Oh my god, what do you use? Oh my god, da 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 da. I'm just like, girl, I can't be telling you all my secret now. Then after that, you're going to be looking like me. You're going to look like me for Halloween. But not every day. That's a little bit too much. Okay. Actually, I'm going to use a different palette for that. Because this is no more. This was my first highlight palette, glow kit palette by Nicole Guerrero by the Anastasia. Obviously, you guys can tell I've been using a lot of Forever Lit, Glow Getter 143, and Forever Young. These are like my top colors. I don't use so much of the Kitty Cat or the Daydream. I don't know why, because they're like orange and I don't know. It doesn't go well with anything. So I'm going to go in with this Glow Kit Sugar palette by the Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is my all-time favorite palette. Actually, there's a story behind this. My best friend bought me this palette and I've been wanting to get it for so freaking long. And it was like during my birthday because it was like December. And it was during my birthday month and I was talking about it and I was like, I need to get this palette. Like, I literally was like saying like, I ran out my first palette and I want to get this glow palette. And it was like probably like a week before my birthday. She like surprised me with it. She's like, I got you something. And I'm like, what is it? I like literally opened it and I, oh my god, I died. I literally died and came back to life, y'all. That's how, like, yeah, I love makeup. Like, my mom buy me makeup all the time. Honestly, for Christmas, I'm like, don't buy me no clothes. Don't buy me anything else. Just give me the money and I go buy me my makeup. Or you can buy me makeup because I love makeup. So I'm going to go in with the Butterscotch highlighter. And what I do is I'll go in with, make sure I have a mirror. So what I do is I'll do and create the tip of my nose, the point. Oh, that is popping. You see that? You see that tip of the nose? Ooh. Girl, she's looking good. She's looking good. Okay. So we're gonna go in and then highlight that bridge at the nose. Make sure you blend it out with your fingers because you don't want it to look like it's a line. And I've seen some girls with like a, they had a highlight and they just draw a freaking line. You see that line right there? That's a no-no. So make sure you guys blend that out. I like to go in a little bit more because I like to highlight even more. Yes. Okay. And then now I'm going to go in with my flat brush. This is by Costo Sense, and this one, it came in with like this like brush little case thingy, and I had a lot of it, but then I don't know what happened to it. When you move around a lot, shit be missing. So I'm gonna go in with the Butterscotch as well, and I'm gonna do this right underneath my cheekbone, on top of my cheekbone, right underneath my eyes. This will kind of make that cheekbone pop. And go in a little bit more. Add more color. Yes! Oh, girl, she is coming to life, honey. So then, get that, dust it off a little bit because you don't want it too much. And I like to do my chin, my hair, and my forehead. And you guys, we're almost done. Let me just go back and deepen up my contour a little bit because I feel like it's just a little too light. Yeah, so let me just go in with this palette because it has a contour palette as well. And it's the Maybelline palette. It's a master contour. I'm going in and grab that little darker part and just go in a little bit more just to kind of deepen it a little bit. And so on this as well. There you go. That looks better. Alrighty. Now we're gonna go on with our lips. So, our lips we're gonna do is this. I get this at a boutique store as well. I think it's by LA Girl. And it is the color Dreamy. I think it's like a pinkish color. What I like about this as well, it's a matte finish. So, I like anything that is matte lipstick because I don't like my makeup to be ruined, so like when I drink or whatever, it doesn't come off, which is pretty cool. Just don't eat anything oily because that shit comes off, so. Then just kind of draw the outline of your lid. And then I just like to put my lip together like this because some of you probably know, if you guys already know me, you probably seen one of my posts on IG that I went out to go get my lips done. So I went to go get my lips done because my lip was like pretty thin. And I went to go get my lips because I wanted more plump. But for some reason, my lip is not plump. So I like to exaggerate my lip a little bit just to make it look more plumper and more bigger. So I don't overdraw on it, but I just like to go kind of outside of the. She's popping now. She's ready. Like to go again with my makeup spray. Alright, so we're done with our makeup. So this is my everyday, not everyday, this is my makeup when I'm gonna go out. So I like it. You guys like it? I like it. So right now I'm gonna show you guys, I usually when I go out, I do my hair and stuff, but I feel like I don't want to do anything to my hair today. So I'm gonna show you guys how I put on my wig, and it's really easy. I always get this, everyone always asks me like, oh, can you show us how do you put on your wig? How do you put on a wig? What do you use? Or what type of product you use? So I'm gonna show you guys how I put on my wig. It literally takes about 10-15 minute, not too long, but I'm gonna show you. But you guys definitely need is got to be gel, and so we're behind my wig. I name all of my girls because I have a specific type of wig I wear when I go out. So this is Megan. And this is Jessica, Demi, we have Miss Iggy. Miss Iggy has some feathers in her hair from her last show last month. And then we have Nikki. But today we're gonna go for a natural color, so we're gonna go with Demi. I love Demi. This is my natural. I always, if you guys see me on my IG post, I always wear this wig. This is my literally to go. I wear everywhere. I wear to the store. I wear to work. Yeah, so just make sure you kind of brush it out a little bit like this. You want to go get yourself a wig cap. This is the only color I have. Obviously, it doesn't match my skin, but it's okay because you're not going to see it. You just need to have your hair out of the way. So what I do is, since my hair is super long, I just like to brush my hair out. I need to get me up. So I brush my hair out like this. And then I go in and I put the cap on. Oops. Like that. And then you want to tuck in the underneath hair, so you can always do however you feel comfortable. And you can always pin this out of the way, like using bobby pin. But I just like pretty much just twist it like this, and then just kind of grab the back and then tuck that in. Make sure it's at the bottom of your nape, because this is where you don't want it to be bulky on top, because when you put on the wig, it's going to be bulky up here. So if you want it to stay lay flat, make sure you, when you like wrap it up and stuff, make sure it's at the bottom of your base, right here where your nape is. And then twist it like this, grab the wig cap, and tuck it in like that. So it looks like this. This is how you tuck it in. This is how I do my wig. And then I like to just bring it up just a little top, just like this. Because I have a lace front wig, and what I like about this lace front wig, it make it look like you have natural, like, hairlines. And I actually did my own baby hair, so I kind of cut my own baby hair in the front. So when I put them on, you can kind of see how I kind of create my baby hair. But since this is natural and my hair is natural on the side, I just like to bring it out a little bit so it looks more realistic. I don't do too much on this side, just wanted to say, because when I put this on, when you guys will see, I put this on, I put it more of a slanted, so it looks more volume on the side here, because I usually tuck it in like this. And then what I do next is I go in with my Got to Be gel, and then you're gonna go right on top where your thing is right here, and just kind of lay it flat down. This will kind of hold the wig cap as well to your scalp. So you want to hold that in. Make sure it's spread out evenly and smooth, because you don't want to leave any bumps or anything like that. So make sure it's spread out really smooth, just like that. You're going to go in. Let me put this on the side though. You're going to grab the front like this and grab the back. The back has a comb right here. It has a comb in the back. So when you are getting wigs, like I said, this is lace front, so you can kind of see the lace here. What I like about this, it's already been pre-plucked, so I don't need to go in there and pluck these hairline, or this parting. And usually, when you guys get wigs, there's wigs that has parting right here that is really thin. That's really fake. Like, no hairline parting like that is really that thin. So it's pretty big. I pretty like it. And it's already been cut and pre-made and whatever. It's synthetic, so you can style it under, I think, over 350 with heat. You don't want to use anything stronger than that, because then it will melt the hair. But I just like it fluffy like that. So what I do, I grab the front, I grab the back. You're gonna put it right on top right here. You're not put it where the glue is, because if you put on the glue, then it's just gonna stick on, and you kind of need to adjust it first. before you actually place it where you want it to be. So make sure you grab the bag, tuck that in. Like this. And then you're gonna grab the front, wherever you wanna place it. So I want it more slanted, so I will always, I like to pull up a little bit more, and then make sure you tuck the back into your hair like that. So like I said, it already, so I kind of already created the baby hair. What I do, I tuck this like this, and I like to bring this out. I even like to tuck it like this to make it look more realistic. So here I feel like the glue is not really sticky, so what I do is I'll tuck it back like this, and I'll just put the glue wherever I need it to be, where I need to stick. So it's pretty much right here. So honestly, I'm not really, I don't need to, usually I will glue the whole thing down, but we're not really, not gonna be dancing or anything like that, so I don't really need to do all that. So I'll just pull it up, make sure that flat lace is flat down. Make sure hair like that. You know, it's got this hair. And then I like to lay that baby hair down so it looks more real. And then what I like to do is I like to tuck that. I'm gonna gel this down so it looks more flat. I like to bring this out so it looks more like that. Then just grab that gel glue again, and you're gonna lay down that baby hair. So you just lay it like this. And then I just like to lay this flat. Everyone does it differently. This is how he does it. And then here's this. So now it's like a lace, so I like to lay that flat down. And that will lay it flat down so it looks like it's your hairline when you pull it back like this, but we're gonna cover that. Alright guys, so this is the look. I'm loving it. I look cute. It came out how I want it to be, and it's perfect. Alright, so we're gonna wrap it up for tonight, and thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel. Click on that subscribe button. Click on that like button. If you guys haven't followed me yet, follow me on IG. Link will be down below, and follow me on Facebook as well. Until next time, I'll be seeing you guys soon. Love you guys.